All right, let me try another video solution coming from our chapter 10. So chapter 10, number 16, and it has the rotational mechanics chapter. And let me give the same hint that I give for all of these when it comes to rotation. It might be best to try to think about what did we do before with translation so we can apply it here to rotation, because that's really the key, is how to do rotation. Is we got to see this analogy. And so this chapter can be either an easy one or a hard one for students, because the material, there's a lot of material, but in theory, it's supposed to be easy because it's just a repeat of the stuff we've already done. But in practice, it can actually come across as being pretty hard here. Let me just, again, show by example. So Zorch, the arch enemy of Superman, decides to slow the Earth's rotation to once every 28 hours by exerting an opposing force at and parallel to the equator. Now, Superman is not immediately concerned because he knows that Zorch can only exert a force of 4 times 10 to the 7th, a little bit greater than a Saturn V rocket. How long must Zorch push with this force in to accomplish this goal? Now, the period gives Superman time to devote to other villains. All right. And so show your steps. Now, this actually is a nice one because it is part kinematics, but also part dynamics. Let me start with the kinematics here. As I read this, I'm hearing something about velocities, initial velocity, an angular velocity, and something about time. And so I'm going to solve here for time. But see, the other part of this is the dynamics, where the angular acceleration is the torque over the rotational inertia. Okay, so looking at this, I know that the new speed, if you will, is going to be one revolution, so that would be 2π radians in 28 hours. And the initial angular speed of the Earth is one revolution, so 2π radians in 24 hours. And so there's our final speed and our initial speed. And of course, because it's slowing it down, it would have a negative angular acceleration. And so maybe not worrying too much about pluses or minus, let me write this as negative the absolute value of the angular acceleration. And then let me simplify these to radians per second. So this would be radians per second squared and time. And so let me just get kind of the base units, and I'll call it the useful units here. And so here is my 2π. And if I divide that by 24 hours, that would be radians per 24 hours. Now, maybe I should write it here. My unit conversion, then, would be to put hours in the top and seconds in the bottom. And, of course, then, knowing that there are 3,600 seconds in 1 hour, this is how hours would cancel off and get radians per second. So, if I take this number, which is already in my calculator, and divide it by 3,600, I get a final angular speed of 6.233 times 10 to the negative 5 radians per second. So that's the final speed. And let me do the same thinking with the initial speed. So the initial speed would be a 2 and a pi divided by 24 hours. And then whatever that is, the same unit conversion here, let me divide that by 3,600. So this would be a 7.272 times 10 to the minus 5. All right. Negative the absolute value multiplied by time. And so let me subtract these two. And so I'll use my calculator's copy feature here. So this is the speed, the final speed. Let's go enter. Let me then subtract the one I just got, enter, and come up with a difference of negative 1.03, and it looks like it'll round to a 9, times 10 to the minus 5 radians per second. And maybe one more step so I can just read it a little better. I'll drop the two negatives. So the absolute value of the angular acceleration multiplied by time then equals 1.039 times 10 to the minus 5 radians per second. So that's what I get from what I'd call the kinematics of it. Now, the dynamics here is Newton's second law. And if I can use that to then get the angular acceleration, I can then get the time. So let me just copy this down and say, okay, the magnitude of the angular acceleration would be the magnitude of the torque over the rotational inertia. And of course, torque is this R perpendicular times force over I. And so let's kind of take a view of Zorch as maybe Zorch is trying to slow down the Earth. Let's say we're viewing the Earth from a top down. So right here is the North Pole. So I'll say, okay, I'm looking down on the North Pole. And the Earth would be spinning towards the east as it moves around, okay? And Zorch, as I said, is somewhere over here at the equator pushing with a force to oppose the motion of the Earth, so to slow it down. And they say this force is only 4 times 10 to the 7th. So it's the amount of push a little bit greater than a Saturn V rocket, which seems like a lot of push, but as you'll see, compared to the size of the Earth, it's not much of a push. So Superman's not real concerned here about this effect, even though it seems like it's a hard push. All right, so the perpendicular distance then would be the radius of the Earth. So let me use that right here, and I'll just put radius and a little sub e for the Earth. And then I'll also put the force in here, 4 times 10 to the 7th newtons. And I suppose I need to go look this up. Although before I do, let me come over here and say, okay, this is then the moment of inertia of some shaped object. So let's go back to that table here in 10 where the moment of inertia, well, we didn't bother to calculate, but we worked out, or we looked at the different shapes. And one of them was a solid sphere. So I'm going to go 2/5 times the mass of the Earth times the radius of the Earth squared. And so this is the solid sphere. And one of the radii will cancel off. And so looking at the absolute value of the angular acceleration, let's see what I have so far. I have 4 times 10 to the 7 newtons in the top. And in the bottom, I have this 2/5, maybe I'll flip it over and call it 5/2, okay? But the two quantities downstairs is the mass of the Earth. Let's see, the mass of the Earth is 6.6. No, that's the radius. 5.98 times 10 to the 24 kilograms. And the radius is 6.63 million meters. Okay. So these numbers are really big, which means, of course, the angular acceleration is really small, which then means the time is really big. So Superman here is not real concerned. So again, let's continue to get some numbers here. So in the top, I'll go 4 times 10 to the 7th. I'll divide that by 5.98 times 10 to the 24. Let me just go back here. Multiply that by a 5 and divide that by a 2. And then finally, the last step will be dividing by 6.63 times 10 to the 6th meters. So the angular acceleration and the absolute value, because really it's slowing it down, so it's a negative. But the absolute value is 2.52 times 10 to the negative 24. And of course, maybe I ought to also kind of look at the units here. Remember, this was a newton, and a newton is a kilogram meter per second squared. Okay. But then we're dividing it by another kilogram, and we're also dividing it by another meter. So kilograms would cancel with kilograms, meter would cancel with meters, and we would be left with 1 over second squared. Which, as we commented before, radians can be either added in or taken out. Since it's not really a unit, it's a clarification. I'll say it again, an angle is actually a distance over another distance. In radians, it's the arc length over the radius. So radians can easily just, be thrown in or thrown out. You don't have to be careful with a unit there. It's clarifier. It's not a real unit. And so I would say I just have this 1 over second squared. That's the real unit, and I'm just going to throw a radian there so it kind of sounds better and it's more clear that I'm talking about radians and not degrees or not gradients, but radians. All right, so knowing this now, we can come back up to this equation here. Where'd it go? So this equation says 1.039 times 10 to the minus 5 radians per second. Then equals, and so here's this angular acceleration, 2.52 times 10 to the negative 24 radians per second squared, and then multiply by t. So unit-wise, seconds are going to cancel off. I guess I might even say radians cancel off, but as I just said, they're not real units, so I could throw them out or not, but they're equal on both sides, so I'll just say I cancel them, but there's no real need to say I cancel them. They're not real units. But now I get time. Okay, so taking this number here in my calculator, 1.039 times 10 to the minus 5, and then dividing it by this last number I just got, 2.52 times 10 to the minus 24, and then hitting enter, although it looks like one of them was a negative. So ignoring the negative here, I got 4.14 times 10 to the 18 seconds. Wow. That's a long, 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 long time. Now this is interesting. I thought I would just glance up here at the solution, and they actually say the radius of the Earth is 6.3 376. You know, maybe, I think I'll look this up afterwards. But anyways, it's close enough that there I have some disagreement here. But this might be, what I use might be the average, and because the Earth is a little oblong, and so it is a little bigger at the equator. So this might be a more appropriate number. But either one is fine. There's going to be a little bit of a rounding here. I said that because your author got 3.96 times 10 to the 18. And that's the difference why. Now, I was kind of curious then whether I use my number or the author's number. This might be better looked in terms of the number of minutes or years, probably years, maybe decades or something, to see, you know, how long this is. Let me get rid of that negative. It's kind of bothering me there. But this is the number of seconds. So if I divide by 60, that's the number of minutes. If I divide that by 60, that's the number of hours. If I divide that by 24, that's the number of days. If I divide that by 365 and a quarter, that's the number of years. Wow. So 1.30 times 10 to the 11th years. Whoa. Let me write that as 130, I'll round to a 1, move that here, times 10 to the 9th, because that's a billion. So 131 billion years. Isn't the age of the Earth 4.5 and the solar system 5 billion years? Yeah, pretty sure that's right. Anyways, obviously it's a ridiculously high number. In fact, the age of the universe is 13.8 billion years. So this is not really going to slow the Earth down by much. even over a time period of the entire age of the universe, let alone the age of the solar system, this is what we'll need. Yep, I can see why the problem says, don't worry, Superman. This will just keep him busy for a while and keep him out of your hair. So, good option. Go deal with other villains, Superman. All right, guys, take care.